Hello everyone, today we are going to discuss about passive transport processes. What are passive transport processes? These processes does not require energy other than that of the molecular motion or the Brownian motion to pass through the lipid bilayer. Now coming to the classification of passive transport processes. Passive transport processes are majorly classified into four types. They are passive diffusion, pore transport, ion pair transport, and facilitated diffusion. In this session, we will discuss the definition and the examples of all four processes. Now coming to passive diffusion. What is passive diffusion? Passive diffusion is a process by which drug molecules spontaneously diffuse from a region of higher concentration to a region of lower concentration, and it is also called as non-ionic diffusion. I repeat once again, passive diffusion is a process by which drug molecules spontaneously diffuse from a region of higher concentration to a region of lower concentration, and it is also called as non-ionic diffusion. Now coming to the driving force, the major driving force per passive diffusion is concentration gradient across the membrane. And when it comes to example, majority of the drugs are weak acids or bases, and 90% of these drugs are usually absorbed through passive diffusion. It is a major absorption mechanism. Now coming to pore transport. What is pore transport? Pore transport is a process by which the drug molecules are transported into the cell through protein channels present in the cell membrane. It is also called as convective transport, bulk flow, or filtration. I repeat once again, pore transport is a process by which the drug molecules are transported into the cell through aqueous protein channels present on the cell membrane. It is also called as convective transport, bulk flow, or filtration. Now coming to driving force, the major driving force for pore transport is the hydrostatic pressure or the osmotic differences across the membrane, and the water flux that promotes such transport is called as solvent drag. Now coming to the examples, low molecular drugs whose molecular weight is less than 100 Daltons and low molecular size molecules are also transported through pore transport. When it comes to water soluble drugs such as water, urea, low molecular weight sugars and organic electrolytes, they are absorbed through pore transport. Even chain like and linear compounds whose molecular weight is up to 400 Daltons, even they are absorbed through pore transport. And pore transport is involved in biological processes such as renal excretion, removal of drug from the cerebrospinal fluid, and the entry of drugs into liver. Now coming to the third process, that is ion pair transport. What is ion pair transport? Ion pair transport is a process by which the drug molecules which are ionized over the entire gastrointestinal pH are absorbed by forming reversible neutral complexes with endogenous ions of GIT like mucin. I repeat once again, ion pair transport is a process by which the drug molecules which are usually ionized over the entire gastrointestinal pH are absorbed by forming neutral complexes, reversible neutral complexes with endogenous ions of GIT like mucin. Now the important points in ion pair transport are a reversible neutral complex is formed, and this complex, it has the required lipophilicity and the aqueous solubility which are essential to cross the biological membrane. Because usually ionized drugs, they don't have sufficient lipophilicity or the aqua solubility to cross the membrane, and by forming such kind of neutral complexes with endogenous ions such as mucin, these complexes, they get the required lipophilicity and aqua solubility, and hence they are easily transported across the lipid bilayer. Now coming to the examples, drugs such as quaternary ammonium compounds, tetracyclines, sulfonic acids are usually transported or absorbed by ion pair transport. Some of the additional examples are propranolol, it forms an ion pair with oleic acid, and similarly quinine, it forms a complex with hexyl salicylate. Now coming to the last process, that is facilitated or mediated diffusion. What is facilitated or mediated diffusion? Facilitated diffusion is a process by which biomolecules such as vitamins, especially examples are vitamin B1, B2 and B12, they form a complex with carrier molecules to pass through the lipoidal membrane, and once in the lumen, they dissociate and then get absorbed. I repeat once again, facilitated diffusion is a process by which biomolecules such as vitamins, they form a complex with carrier molecules to pass through the lipoidal membrane, and once in the lumen, they dissociate and then get absorbed. Now coming to the examples and some of the important points regarding facilitated or mediated diffusion. It is a carrier mediated transport and it is a capacity limited process because we have limited number of carriers, and it follows mixed order kinetics or nonlinear kinetics, which is best explained by Michael Menten's equation. Now coming to the examples, as I have said earlier, vitamin B1, B2 and B12, they are absorbed through facilitated or mediated diffusion. And when it comes to B12, B12 forms a complex with the intrinsic factor IF, which is a glycoprotein that is produced by the gastric parietal cells. And this B12 and intrinsic factor complex is transported across the membrane by a carrier system. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe for further videos on Gpat.